So a lot of you guys have been asking, Nate, what is the fastest way to make money in 2020? What can I do to make money now? How can I make money instantly? There's really only one way to do this for the fastest money possible.
And that's by making smart decisions. So in this video, I'm gonna show you a number of ways that you can make money legally, with an L, legitimate ways to make some money this year. And hey, this isn't gonna be the typical video that tells you to drive for Uber or to sell on eBay or to start a YouTube channel that shows people how to make money. Wait, was that in the script? Yeah, so definitely don't try to wear a ski mask outside of the bank. That was a terrible idea for an intro. But hey, for real, okay, there's gonna be a number of things in this video that I'm excited to share with you guys. I actually did a poll on Instagram just the other day to ask people what were some ideas that they had. So we collectively kind of brought ideas together. I'm not some type of millionaire guru who's gonna show you like how to make tons of money. I'm just a random person on the internet. So if you're willing to listen to this video, I think you might find some value in it. Not all of these ideas I have practiced myself or made millions from with myself, but I just thought that they were genuinely unique, interesting ideas that you can make money with. So without any further ado, let's get started with this video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and let's get into this. I think I'm pretty excited for this. So the first one is online surveys. All right, no. Who actually makes money with online surveys? Like, I don't know anybody who's made more than like 50 cents in a day by taking online surveys. That is the biggest waste of time. Correctly, if I'm wrong, I mean, I've yet to meet someone who's actually like, yeah, I'm a professional online survey taker. I just don't really see that happening. I also want to remind you that if you're looking to make $500 an hour by clicking buttons, there might be sort of a problem there, because in general, what we have to remember is that you're gonna get paid for what you're worth. You're gonna get paid for the value that you're providing. So anytime that you see somebody saying that you can get $1,000 a day by just clicking your mouse and doing absolutely nothing but taking online surveys, that's probably not the case. They're probably just gonna steal all of your information and you're gonna end up pretty sad. But one that I think is actually really interesting, this is really for a lot of the college students out there, is to sell study guides, or essentially just go to class and take notes and then sell those notes at the end of the semester. Now, I know personally that when I was in college, really hope my mom's not watching this video right now, but I really never went to class. Bad decision, I know, but what I would do is at the end of the semester or right before exams, I would go to this study group. They would charge like $50 per study group, and there was one before every exam, and I'd pay $50 because I didn't go to class, and so I would just pay this lump sum amount of money. There were 100, 150 kids in this classroom, somebody giving you a crash course of everything that you should have been learning in the class over the course of the semester. So $50, 100 kids in the classroom, do the math on that, that's $5,000 in a classroom that company was making from that. Now, this is at a big university at Penn State, so they had a lot of students available for that, and they had like 8 classrooms going at the same time, so they were literally some days pulling in tens of thousands of dollars. You could do this on a smaller scale. You could simply just go to class, take some notes, and then sell those notes at the end of the semester. I know personally, I paid a lot of people for notes at the end of the semester when they post them to a Facebook group and say, $20 a piece, I'll send you a PDF with all of the notes, and I was paying a lot of money for that. And that's because people are willing to pay whatever it takes to get a good grade in college, especially in today's environment. So the next one, this video is not sponsored by Bud Light, but if they want to sponsor me, just reach out. The next one is to remove junk. Now, look, I know everybody wants to make money from their laptop and just do absolutely nothing and like wipe your ass and make 10 grand. But if you were willing to get your hands a little bit dirty, this is a business model that we've seen people make millions of dollars from. Look at, I think it's 1-800-GOT-JUNK. These people made millions of dollars from just picking up people's crap that they have at their house. So I really hope my mom's not watching this video, because I don't know about you, but I remember like there's just like a TV outside my parents' house, just like in the yard. There's like tires and just other, just like a pile of junk that we have. And you know, we don't know what to do with it. A lot of people find themselves in that situation. They have things that they just piling up, like old appliances. They have like an oven from like 30 years ago in their basement. Their garage is filled with just crap. People need to get rid of it, and that's why you could start a junk removal business. Now, the the logistics of this depends on the situation, how hard it would be to start this. If obviously you have a truck or you have a car that you can get a tow package and buy or rent a trailer and just remove junk for people and then literally take some of that junk and then sell it, or you could take it to the scrapyard, make money from it twice, kind of double dipping there. But it's definitely a business idea that I think is pretty interesting, pretty straightforward. Post those ads to Facebook or to Craigslist or even to your local newspaper if people still use those anymore, and make some money off of that. So the next one is a really cool idea, and it's to essentially make money by making something green. And what I mean by this is to find something in society at the moment and find a way to make it more environmentally friendly, which can be a business model in itself. So this is a really a win-win situation. It's probably like a feel-good business, but also you can make some money because, you know, at the end of the day, we do need to pay our rent, right? And so, for example, selling reusable bags instead of plastic bags, right? Custom bags. There's a lot of things that people can do to be more environmentally conscious, and they're willing to pay more money for that because they want something that's reusable. Like, for example, hydro flasks. People pay like $40 or $50 for hydro flasks, and they are generally better for the environment because you're not using a plastic bottle every single day, throwing it out every single day and wasting so much plastic. So finding anything, and this is kind of like a broad idea, but I thought it was really important to include in this video, is just finding something that you can turn environmentally friendly, which in a lot of cases you can charge more money for because people are willing to pay more because they feel better about it. And it's just overall a great business model. So taking something and turning it green and making money off of it is a pretty cool idea. All right, so the next idea is to become a property manager. Now, if you don't have enough money to start investing into real estate, or maybe you just don't want to start buying properties, you don't like the idea of it, you can still make money in real estate. And so I have a number of friends who are real estate investors, and for most investors, when they start, they're usually managing their own property at first when they get their first couple of properties, which means that you have to think about all the little things that go into being a landlord or being a real estate investor, okay? And so being a property manager, what you're doing here is you're working with real estate investors who might buy an apartment complex or they might buy some houses, but they don't have the time or the resources to go and show people their apartments, to fill vacancies, to find new tenants, to make sure that everything's running smoothly, to help people unclog toilets. So you can become a property manager and take a percentage, sort of a fee, from the real estate investor or whoever owns the land from the landlord, and you can take a fee there from whatever the tenant might pay them. And this is, you know, something that I've seen people go from a few percent closer to 7 or 8%. I'm not an expert on this, so if you want to get into this, just do some Google searches, read some books about it, talk to some real estate investors about who they use as a property manager. But a lot of real estate investors who are big need property managers to manage their properties for them. And this is something that you can do with not very much experience. Now, I don't want to make this sound easy. By no means is it an easy operation. And this is because a business that people can scale to millions of dollars, but it's something that doesn't have a barrier to entry in the sense that you need some type of college degree. This is something that as long as you're willing to put in the effort and you're willing to really think about how you're going to make this a priority and make this a business, then it's something that you can certainly consider pursuing. So look into that if you're interested in something like property management. Now, the next one here is also actually tied to real estate. And I see people doing this, not very often, but it's a very lucrative idea. And that is to essentially think about buying land wholesale and then selling it retail, right? So the way that we can describe this is think about Walmart, right? They're gonna buy products by the pallet. They're gonna buy products by the truck. They're gonna buy a shipping container of products, and then they're going to sell those individually in the store. And they're making money because they're buying it wholesale and then breaking it up and selling each one individually at a higher cost per item. You could do the same thing with real estate. And I've seen people do this with lots. For example, they'll buy a plot of land and then they'll split it up into 10 different lots and they'll sell each one of those lots for a higher piece or price per amount of acreage that they're buying. So for example, if you bought 100 acres for $100,000 and then you split it up into 10 different lots of 10 acres and you sold each one of those for $20,000, you could theoretically double your money. Now, it's more difficult to sell raw land than it is to sell actual houses or buildings, but it's still something that I see people doing where they'll buy big plots of land and then break them up into smaller parcels and sell those smaller parcels for a higher cost per unit or higher price per unit. And that's one I want to share with you. And look, hey, if you don't have the money to do it, there's always sort of a workaround to this. I know a lot of people who have money that they're sitting on and they don't know where to invest it. They are looking for somebody to partner with who maybe doesn't have the money, but they have the time or they have the motivation to go out and do these deals, and then you get a percentage of that. So you can find somebody who is an investor who's willing to do this, to put in the money, and then you put in the time side of it to make something happen with a partnership like this. It happens all the time. Next idea is to sell on eBay. Now, well, okay, you've probably already heard of this, but this is sort of a different approach to it, and that is by not actually having the products yourself, of going out to auctions and yard sales and then buying them and then trying to resell them on eBay or on Craigslist or other areas. We've talked about that in the past, and it's certainly something you can do, but we're gonna put a different spin on this, and this is actually a different opportunity where you can essentially sort of sell other people's products for them and then take a commission, take a piece off the top of whatever profit they're making or whatever the sale is that they're making. So I was thinking back to ways that I was making money when I was much younger, when I was a teenager, and one of the things that I would do, I kind of feel bad about it actually, it sort of took advantage of my dad, but I would say, hey dad, you have this snow plow here, you're probably not gonna ever use it, I can sell it for you for $1,200, I'll take a 20% cut, and you don't have to worry about anything. And somehow he said yes to it. Maybe he just wanted to be nice to me and help me make some money. But from that, you know, if I sold it for $1,200, I can make 20% and make $240 profit for not having to worry about expenses, not having to worry about profitability. I was just making a percentage on the top of everything. And there's a lot of people who don't know how to sell on eBay. They have a computer or their phone and they just don't know how to sell it online, or they don't want to have to deal with selling it online. Maybe they don't have the time to do it. And so you could just become the person who says, hey, I can sell that for you. I'm just going to take a piece off the top, and I think everybody's going to be happy overall. A lot of people are willing to do that, so it's definitely a cool business opportunity for you. So kind of going along with that last idea that we just mentioned, there's actually another really cool opportunity, and that's to, we're going to call this old school drop shipping. So what happens here in this case is, let's say that in your local area, you can sell a cord of firewood, basically a truckload or trailer load of firewood for, say, $300 per cord. Now, with that, if you could find a source from that where you could, say, buy it for $150 a cord, make $150 profit, and then not have to actually go and do any of the work, this actually does happen. I know people who do this, and it's pretty lucrative, pretty interesting. So for example, you can post an ad for a product or a service for a certain price, then you get that customer, you send somebody else who you can buy for a cheaper price to go deliver it to that customer, and you're essentially just the middleman here. So somebody in my family just last week was getting their roof repaired, and they noticed that the person who gave the quote of, said, you know, how much it's going to cost to fix the roof and put a whole new roof on the house, wasn't actually doing any of the work. They just outsourced the work to another company, to a bunch of other people, and they essentially just sat there in their car and watched it happen without having to do very much. So becoming the middleman here, this is the idea in this point, is to essentially become the middleman and find a way where you can just buy something for a certain price, sell it for a higher price, and just send those people to each other. It's basically drop shipping, but old school, with services and things in the local area. You can do this with furniture, you can do this with TVs, you can just send people to other areas and become the middleman to make some money off the top. What's great about this is that in a lot of cases, you're not gonna get left holding the bag with having products that you don't know how to sell, because you're only buying them when you know that you're about to sell one. So that's a really cool idea that I thought. Now, this next one here, it's not necessarily a business, but I thought I'd include it in this list because I haven't mentioned it before in the past, and it's just a nice way to make some extra money on the side, and that is to become a referee, an official, an umpire. My uncle does this, and he makes $50 per game that he does for baseball. He'll do two games after work in the summer. He'll make $100. And it's just some great extra spending money that he can use for vacations or use for other just fun things in his life that he wants to spend some money on, but doesn't want to tap into his pay from work. He wants some extra money on the side. It's a great opportunity. And, you know, honestly, I think he would almost do it for free because he just loves to do it. He loves sports. He loves baseball. So becoming an official for a sport, trust me, there's a lot of different officials out there that are needed for high school sports, for even, you know, older leagues. There's a lot of different officials that are are needed for that. So just look into that in your local area if you want to make some extra money. You're not going to become a millionaire by being a baseball umpire or a football referee, but it's certainly something that can help pay the bills. Now, another idea is to buy and sell domains. Now, most people think that this is something that people were doing in the 90s and you can't really do it anymore. But I have a friend who just bought a domain, actually it was about a year ago now, maybe a year and a half ago, who bought a domain for about $5,000. Maybe it was $4,000, but it was at least $4,000 that he paid for a domain name. And so I actually own over a dozen different domains for certain categories and different businesses. If you're interested in buying some domains, maybe send me an email, especially the financial domains that I have for websites. But you know, you might pay $20 a year or $12 a year for having a domain, and then you can sell it for thousands of dollars potentially in the future. You're not always going to be able to sell them. And also, just a little forewarning, don't want to do any cyber squatting. There's definitely laws on it where, for example, if you bought McDonald's.com for some reason, like their domain expired and they didn't realize it, if you bought McDonald's.com and you thought you could sell it back to McDonald's for millions of dollars, you probably wouldn't be able to do that because they own the rights to that. They have the trademark for it, so they could get it from you. But for example, if you had a website like coffee.com, well, you can't really trademark coffee.com, and so therefore you could sell that for millions of dollars. And some domain names have been sold for tens of millions of dollars. Ones like casino.com or money.com or a lot of these smaller, shorter ones, but there's still a lot of ones. And trust me, because I've done way too many hours of research on this, buying domains for myself that I could potentially sell in the future, where I spent so much time finding these domains, you can still find some really good short words, finding two combinations of words that people are willing to buy in the future. You don't know when somebody's gonna open a business next year and they want that exact domain that you have, and you can sell it for a lot of money. And you don't even have to do this with domains. You can do this with different types of social media. So Instagram handles. I know people who pay like $10,000 for an Instagram handle because they want like this cool short little Instagram handle. So sort of being on top of the game, finding the next sort of big social media platform and just taking up a bunch of the usernames and potentially selling those in the future. For example, if a new social media program comes out, or an app comes out, and I can get the username just Nate or Bob or Mike, somebody down the road, if that social media platform becomes very large, is going to pay me a lot of money for doing that, for selling it to them. Okay, so that's a really cool opportunity. Just be on top of the game with that. So there's two more here that I want to share with you, and one of them is not necessarily a business. It's not even really a side hustle. It's just kind of a part-time job, but it's still pretty interesting. And that's by being a substitute teacher. Very flexible with this. On the days that you can do it, you just get called in whenever you have the opportunity to do it, and you can make $100 a day, depending on the school district that you're in. And it's relatively easy work, although I've never done it, so I can't speak for that. I probably shouldn't say that it's easy. I think a lot of substitutes get some pretty hard times. But okay, it's definitely something that I want to just include on this list because it's just a way to make some extra money on the side. And the final one here is not one that's going to make you millions of dollars. I don't know why I saved it until last, but I had a friend in college who would buy up students graphing calculators at the end of the semester and then sell them on eBay for triple what he would buy them for. So he would buy these expensive calculators. If you've taken calculus or any other type of like higher level math, you'll know that, you know, in a lot of cases, you're gonna need a pretty decent calculator, a lot of them being ones that are over $100 that you have to buy them for. And then he would just buy them off of all the students who were graduating. He would go in at the end of the semester and just pull up a ton of calculators from students and then flip them. And, you know, he was able to pay a good portion of his rent just from doing this little side gig on the side. And you can kind of expand this idea to find other opportunities like that. So a quick little bonus here before we finish this video is I want to remind you guys that the election is coming up in the United States, 2020 presidential election. It's really big. Everybody's watching it. This is a great opportunity to make some money. And I've talked about this before in the past, so this isn't going to be like one of the points that we're making here. But there's a lot of money in elections. There's a lot of money flowing around. And in the 2016 election, I was selling all kinds of different political bumper stickers from both sides of the political spectrum. I really didn't care. I was just trying to make money. I didn't really like any of the candidates. But yeah, it's definitely an opportunity. You can make yard signs for political campaigns, talk to your local campaigns for state representative, for Congress, and find out what they need. They might need yard signs, bumper stickers, apparel, all kinds of stuff. There's a lot of money flowing into campaigns. So just look into that. I think it's one of the best, coolest ideas every time that an election season comes up. I love politics. Okay, guys, Peace out. Hopefully everybody found some value in this video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to the channel down below. Leave a comment on some of your favorite ideas, and I'll see everybody in next week's video.